I just closed up my apartment in Los Angeles, and one of the things that I had to send to Chicago, which is my home, was a cat. It was a Siamese. I didn't know this, but you have to get a little case, and you have to get a health certificate, and they give you pills you give to them, and it knocks them out, you know. And I've never seen a high cat before, you know. And, it's, and the only way you can tell he's high is he keeps saying, like meow, man. But otherwise, you can't tell. I had kind of a traumatic experience, I think it was, with a cat. I didn't know this when I got it, but when the cat gets to be about, 8 months old, you have to make a decision, see? Now the thing is, are you going to keep him in the apartment all the time, or will he run free? If he's going to run free, you don't have to make a decision. If you're going to keep him in the house, you better make a decision. One of the symptoms they tell me about the time you should start thinking about is when they start crawling up the drapes and walking across the top of the ceiling. See? They're very much like humans in that regard. And of course, this had been weighing on my mind for several weeks, and forget it if you try to put yourself in the cat's place. Just forget it. You've got to take a detached attitude toward this thing. So anyway, I made the decision. I decided to get George, Nutty George, fixed. They call it fixed. And it is fixed, let me tell you. So I sent him to the vet, and I got him back in a couple days. And ever since then, all he does is sit on top of the television and just stare at me. Why don't you play with a catnip or something? I told you I'm sorry, George.